The Philippine Pole Body holds its first hearing on a petition to disqualify Smartmatic from participating in the procurement process for the 2025 elections. Victoria Tulan filed this report.
Because of alleged irregularities in the 2022 national elections, the group of former DICT Secretary Eliseo Rio Jr. and former COMELEC Commissioner Augusto Lagman is asking the Commission on Elections to not allow elections technology company Smartmatic from possibly participating in the procurement process for the 2025 election. In the first hearing on the petition today, petitioners alleged that Smartmatic was not able to meet minimum standards as required in their contract. Smartmatic supplied the vote counting machines used in the 2022 automated election. One of the many allegations is that 32 election returns were transmitted to COMELEC's transparency server even before the VCMs started transmitting. Petitioners also raised the possibility of fraud since 20,300 modems used just one IP or internet protocol address. The petitioners clarified that they are not questioning the results of the 2022 elections, just Smartmatic's qualification. The camp of Smartmatic answered the allegations one by one. According to the company's counsel, the time of transmission of election returns through the transparency server is reflected in the ninth copy of the election receipt. He said petitioners might have used the time on the first eight copies, which is why they assumed that ERs were transmitted earlier. As for the IP address, Smartmatic said there is no irregularity with using one IP address since the unofficial parallel count made by election watchdog PPCRB matched with the final election results. The COMELEC and Bank, particularly Commissioner Ernesto Masada Jr., questioned the petitioners if their prayer to disqualify Smartmatic is not premature since the procurement process has not yet started. The camp of the petitioners said they are taking on a preemptive approach with their action since Smartmatic may opt to bid. COMELEC Chairman George Garcia asked the petitioners if they are amenable to open 10 selected ballot boxes from different areas of the country to settle the issue once and for all. The petitioners said they agree to this. COMELEC and Bank will discuss the suggestion. After this, the hearing was ended before 12 noon and both camps were ordered to submit additional documents.
The Philippine Transportation Chief sues two persons for cyber libel for supposedly linking him to corruption at the Land Transportation Regulator. Secretary Jaime Bautista lodged the complaints Tuesday against transport leader Mar Valbuena and journalist Ira Panganiban. He was previously tagged in the corrupt practices at the LTFRB following claims by whistleblower Jeffrey Tumbado. Valbuena, in a statement, decried the accusation as harassment and abuse of power. Panganiban, meanwhile, called out Bautista for singling him out and maintained he was only doing his job.
The Philippine government is set to acquire three brand new C-130 Super Hercules aircraft for the Air Force. The Defense Department says it has issued a notice to proceed to Lockheed Martin, which clinched the project. That is part of the second horizon of the Armed Forces Modernization Program. DND spokesperson Arsenio Andalong says the aircraft will empower the Air Force to effectively meet the demands of the military's tactical missions. Two C-130s are expected to be delivered on 2026 and another in 2027.
Meantime, the House of Representatives had to take down its website due to suspicious and unusual activities. House Secretary General Reginald Velasco said taking down the website was a precautionary measure to allow them to reinforce cybersecurity protocols. On Sunday, the lower chamber's website was defaced. It was restored on Monday. An official said it immediately received a deluge of visitors, some of which were from abroad. The House's IT experts explained an overnight scan found backdoors that hackers could exploit.
Hackers once again attempt to break their way into the online system of Philippine government institutions. The Senate says it recorded a spike in cyber attacks on its website the same day the website of the House of Representatives was defaced. The Senate added its tech team is on top of the situation and is constantly monitoring any further attacks. The Bureau of Immigration also shares hackers have attempted to breach the agency's website, but they assured none had been successful. A number of government agencies have fallen victim to hackers in recent weeks. These include the Philippine Statistics Authority, PhilHealth, and the Science and Technology Department.
Now here at home, thousands of Bangsamoro people joined a march in Cotabato City for a free Palestine. They're calling for an end to Israel's occupation of Palestinian land. The protesters also urged America to be fair in its treatment of both Palestine and Israel as they sought for a peaceful end to the conflict. Meanwhile, the Armed Forces of the Philippines says it has not monitored any threat of sympathy attacks in the country amid the war in the Middle East.
The Commission on Elections holds a village caravan to step up its information drive on mall voting. Let's get more details from our correspondent Vivian Gulia. Viv?
Hi, Denise. Less than 2 weeks before the barangay in Sangguniang, Kabataan polls, the Commission on Elections held on Tuesday a barangay caravan in three Metro Manila cities to step up the information drive on mall voting, which will be piloted in selected areas this October 30th. Officials of the Commission on Elections visited malls in the cities of Las Piñas, Parañaque, and Pasig. First, residents will cast their vote this coming youth and village elections instead of the usual voting precinct in school. Hundreds of voters participated in Tuesday's caravan. COMELEC chairperson George Garcia, who led the assembly in a mall in Las Piñas City, expressed optimism that mall voting will help improve voter turnout on election day. Among the advantages he cited are the bigger space, better ventilation, and convenience of the new voting site. He noted that holding mall voting in selected areas has no additional cost to the government, as malls agreed to provide the facility without charge. COMELEC also gave assurances that the security in mall voting will be tight. It has coordinated with the Philippine National Police, the Armed Forces of the Philippines, and the Philippine Coast Guard on security preparations for the upcoming elections. 11 areas in the country will pilot mall voting this October 30th. Of this number, 9 are in Metro Manila, 1 in Cebu, and 1 in Legazpi City, Albay. The COMELEC estimates around 200,000 voters will vote for the first time in malls on that day. During the caravan, the COMELEC also tackled vote buying, premature campaigning, and early voting hours. Back to you, Denise.
Thanks, Viv.